Hello and welcome to the video by Trump Excel. I am Sumit Bansal, and in this video I will show you how to count the number of cells that contain text. Now in this data, this list that I have various data types that can be entered in Excel. So for example, in the first three cells I have text strings, in the next three I have numbers, then I have special characters, I have a blank cell, and then I have logical values. Now in case of blank cell, it could either be a cell like this which contains nothing, or it could be something like this where I have an apostrophe here. Now we use apostrophe when we want to convert any data into text. So if I want to convert a number into text, I would start with an apostrophe. I would type say 123, and when I press enter, this is aligned to the left, which is a property for text, and this is not a number as of now. If I remove the apostrophe, then this becomes a number and gets aligned to the right. So some people use apostrophe, and you may get your data from a database or from a colleague or from some person who has entered an apostrophe just because he wanted to convert the data that is entered into text. So this could be one case. The other case could be that you're using a formula that returns an empty string, and when you hit enter here, you would see that it shows nothing. It looks like a blank cell, but it's not a blank cell. So we also have certain cases where you may see a blank cell but has an apostrophe or an empty string. Now I will show you first how to count text, the number of cells that contain text. And to do that, I would use a count if function. So I would use count if, and here this would be my entire range. Let me press F4 to lock it, and the criteria here would be a wild card, and I would use the wild card asterisk, and an asterisk here would represent any number of characters. So there are three wildcard characters in Excel. Let me do one thing. Let me first talk about the wildcard characters. So we have asterisk, we have question mark, and we have tilde. Now, an asterisk would represent any number of characters. It could be 0, it could be 1, it could be 2, it could be 100. So any number of characters could be represented by an asterisk. A question mark would represent one character. It could be any character, but it could only be one character. And a tilde is used to identify wildcards. So in this video, we'll not be using tilde. I would be using these first two wildcard characters. Now let's create that formula. So I would use count if. I would select this entire range, press F4 to lock it, and my criteria within double quotes would be the asterisk. Now when I hit enter, you would see that I have 6 here, and let's see how we are getting 6 here. So these three cells are counted. These three cells are not counted, because whenever you use a wildcard character in COUNTIF, it does not count the numbers. So here, a wildcard character means that it could be any number of characters. It would also include the blank cell, and in this case it would count these first three cells. It would count these two special characters and this cell, which is A9. It would also count the blank cell, but it would not count the numbers, and it would not count the logical values. So if you want to count those cells that contain text, special characters, and empty strings, then you can use this asterisk wildcard character. But what if you don't want to count blank cells, because this is something that does not have any text and it is really not important in your calculation? Then you would only want to count these three cells and the special characters. And to do that, we would modify this criteria a bit. We would include a question mark here. And what this does is, the criteria here becomes question mark asterisk, which means that there should at least be one character in the cell. And then there could be any number of characters. So even if there is one character, then it is counted. But if it is a string which has no character in it, then it is not counted. So now when I hit enter, it gives me 5, because it would count these three cells and it would count these two special characters, but it would not count this blank. So this is a very useful formula, because often is the case when we get these empty blank cells which we do not want to count. Now all is good, but what about these logical formulas? What if I also want to count these formulas, these values? Then to do that, I would have to extend this formula and include another part, which is the sum product part. And here I would have to check whether this is a logical value or not. So to do that, I would use isLogical, and I would simply select this entire range and I would hit F4. Now what happens here is, if you select this is logical part and you press F9, it would tell you whether there is a logical value in a cell or not. So in these first 9 cells, there is no logical value, therefore you get 9 falses here. But in the remaining 2, the last 2, there is a logical value. It could be either true or false, and hence it returns true. Let me press Ctrl Z to go back to the formula. Now what I'll also do is I would include a double negative here, and what the double negative does is, now if I select this entire formula and press F9, it returns an array of 0 and 1. So now what I can do is I can add these. So let me press Ctrl Z and go back, and all I need to do is use this formula. If I select this entire sum product part and press F9, it returns 2, which means that the first part would count all the cells which have at least one character, so it would count the first 3 and the special characters, and the sum product part would count the cells which have logical values, which would be 2 in this case. So now if I hit enter, it gives me 7, because now there are 7 cells here which have text characters in it. It could be these pure strings, it could be special characters, and it could also be these logical values. So this is how you can use a combination of different formulas and wildcard characters to create formulas that would count the cells with text, or with text and blanks, or with text and logical values. So that's it in this video. I hope you found this useful. Thank you and have a nice day.